What is your Tinder horror story? My roommate loves Tinder, and she's brought back numerous visitors, which is fine, except for the fact that the apartment is tiny and we share a room, and also the fact that my roommate doesn't really care what I end up seeing, and, as it turns out, most guys don't care about having another girl in the room either. Some take it as an opportunity to ask me to join. My roommate is my Tinder nightmare. Finally, started seeing a girl off Tinder. It was going well for about 2 weeks and thought she was pretty cool. Then things started getting weird. She used to always joke about killing me. I thought it was okay the first few times, but then it got annoying. I told her to stop and she kept doing it. IDK if it was because she thought it was funny that it freaked me out or what. Anyways, told me she has a shotgun in her room. Yikes. Long story short, I told her I didn't want to see her anymore. She didn't like that. For the next 3 weeks she's absolutely hounding me. Calls me constantly. Shows up at my work asking for me. Keeps coming over to my apartment. She actually knocked on my door for 30 minutes. When I didn't answer, she went around back and started knocking on my bedroom window. Got really concerned for a while, but eventually she gave up. I went on a date with a guy and the entire time he was talking about how men are superior and how there have been scientific studies to show that women have an emotional reaction to the color red when they see it. I wonder why he was single. I'm probably too late, but here it goes. Sorry for the wall of text. My first and only Tinder date, I started talking to a cute guy. We hit it off really well. We'll call him Greg. Greg lived in a town nearly an hour away, so we texted for about 2 weeks before we decided to meet due to schedules. During this time, Greg consistently attempted to wow with his food knowledge. I work in the fine dining restaurant industry, often telling me about what meal he was cooking for him and his roommates each night. After several days of talking, he then asks me to come to his house so he would be able to cook for me. I oblige, figuring what's the worst that could happen. I've talked to him several times and felt okay about the whole situation. The day comes and we meet somewhere neutral and I follow him to his house, all the while him explaining how excited he is to cook for me. We arrive at his place, everything is going really great. He's exactly as I pictured him and his personality fits me perfect. Dinner time rolls around and he tells me he needs to go downstairs to begin prep. I become eager and say I'd love to help. He insists I stay on the couch and relax. We continue to talk across rooms and I can't see what's going on in the kitchen. He puts something in the oven and says it will be ready in just a bit and that he made extra in case I was hungry. 15 minutes late, Greg leaps off the couch to a timer and runs to the kitchen. He brings sauces first, saying that they are the best part. He lays ketchup, ranch and barbecue sauce on the table. I begin to get confused, wondering what he made as he refused to tell me, announcing that he wanted to keep it a secret. Greg returns to the kitchen to retrieve the plates. He walks in and carries a turkey platter to the table. I gaze into what had to be no less than 3 bags of frozen fries he had displayed on a turkey platter for our dinner. He looks at me eagerly, awaiting my reaction for me to lose it. I begin uncontrollably laughing and his smile drops as I say, "This is great, thank you." Assuming this was a gag meal and he had prepared dinner to follow. No, Greg invited me to dinner to cook me his specialty, frozen French fries. They were delicious fries, and the sauce was the best part. Met up with a really hot but curious girl. I'm a lesbian. This girl had only ever been with men and wanted to experiment with girls. She was stupidly hot, like hot. We matched and we chatted for like 2 days. I soon found out we had no common ground at all. Like, none. However, she wanted to meet, and me being the frisky les gremlin I am, agreed just because she was hot and I could take her girl on girl virginity. We agreed to meet one day, picked her up and we went for drinks. Walked back to mine and chatted a little more over alcoholic root beer and Breaking Bad. We started making out. She took off my bra. I took off hers. She took my pants off. I took hers off. We started kissing, touching, feeling. She starts fingering me. I can tell straight away she is a first timer. She starts jabbing at my poor vag with her half inch acrylics. I tell her to slow down a little and be a little more gentle about it. All of a sudden, she bursts into tears and says she's not ready. I tell her it's fine, blah blah. She ends up staying at my place and we cuddle for the night until I sobered up enough to drive her back home in the morning. later the next day I go for a pee and realize it stings like a bee and my pee smells dreadful and is cloudy. Run to the doctor's because I'm a casual hypochondriac and take a pee sample. Doctor sticks the paper in my pee and yup, straight away it shows I have a UTI. I didn't pee after little Miss Bacurius scratched my insides out. B gave me a UTI and blue balls. Comma blue balls. Blue walls. I dated someone I met from Tinder for a month. Seemed good on paper. Master's student. Yoga teacher. Cultured. Etc. Found out she was doing H and didn't consider that a big problem. I actually had to explain to her the definition of a high-functioning addict because she felt that having a job and going to school meant the H thing wasn't a problem. We broke up and she went back to her junkie XBF. Bullet dodged. Edit. LOL, all the people PMing me trying to confirm if I was simultaneously dating their own crappy GF. If you find yourself wondering if I'm describing your GF, you should just break up with her immediately. My Tinder horror story is very funny looking back. The girl comes over. She couldn't get there until 7:30-ish. I had some pizza warming in the oven just in case she was hungry. For some stupid reason, I put the pizza in the box to warm in the oven. It was a real pizza from a pizza place. She wasn't hungry, so we jump right into making out. Clothes get strewn. We head back towards the bedroom. I go into the kitchen and turn the oven off, but leave the pizza in there. A few minutes later, I am going down on her and I hear a beeping. I lift up my head and say, "What was that?" She says, "I think it was a truck backing up." I hop up just to check in the oven. Without my glasses on, I had accidentally missed off by 1/8 of an inch and my crappy oven went to broil. The beeping was telling me it was preheated. I stupidly opened the oven and smoke comes billowing out. Then the box bursts into flames. I am standing there butt naked and I start yelling, "Frick, frick, oh crap." Then she comes running in totally naked as I pull the box out thinking I am going to pour water on it. It was stressful, I don't know what I was thinking. I set it on the stove and then she hits it with a dish towel. Sparks and burnt crap go all over my kitchen but the box is still on fire. My sink is so full of crap that I can't get the box in there. She yells bathtub, so I pick up a goddamn burning box and run to my bathroom over the carpet, my shower mat and past the shower curtain. All very flammable. The entire top of the pizza box was either in flames or charred and flaking off as I ran. Remember, we are both totally naked this whole time. So imagine a naked, screaming man running through his crappy apartment with a burning pizza box in his hands. That was me. This was a date. I throw the box in the bathtub and turn the shower on. She was so super cool about it. She helped me clean everything up. And then we got dressed and just stood outside for a while. She could tell I was really freaked out, and kept reassuring me all was well. Then we went back in and I went down on her again. Then we had sex. We still hang out often and have a lot of fun together. I still have burn marks in my bathtub and on my bathroom door. Comma, I stupidly opened the oven and smoke comes billowing out. Then the box bursts into flames. To extinguish an oven fire, just close the oven door and turn off the oven. The inside of the oven can easily handle any flames and the oven door staying closed deprives the fire of the oxygen that needs to keep burning. I had been on a couple of dates with this girl that I met on Tinder, and learned that she was really into the rockabilly scene. I found out that a local nightclub was hosting a rockabilly themed night and so I took her. She had dressed to the nines and we were having a great time in the club. Suddenly this guy accidentally tipped a drink on her 50s style dress. The guy apologized profusely. She storms over to grab her coat and bag and on the way out she just punches the guy in the face. Everyone in the club was shocked. I took her outside and told her she couldn't react like that, and that's when she took her heel off and hit me square in the face for siding with the guy. Blood everywhere. I never answered her calls after that. Oh, and she used to be a stripper and cam girl. This adds nothing to the story but I just like telling people. Pew pew. I met this guy on Tinder and we had a couple really fun dates. I was pretty into him. So on our third date, I decided I wanted to have sex with him. He took me out for a really nice date and then he invited me back to his place for a glass of wine. One thing led to another and we started making out on his couch, fully clothed. But this lasted forever. I was ready to go, if you know what I mean. I didn't want to make out the whole night. So I decided to take matters into my own hands and I took off all of my clothes. Then he sits up, still fully clothed, and looks at me and says, "I can't have sex with you. I have a STD." Possibly most awkward moment of my life. I tried to be super nice about it, but I promptly got dressed and left. And as many of my friends have pointed out, I am extremely grateful that he told me. That's really big of him. Nothing but props to that dude. En route to the worst date ever, this guy texted me from the burrito place we were meeting to tell me he'd already ordered me the salad. I repeat, salad, at a burrito place. Also, was this the past? Was I now incapable of placing my own food order? Anyway, after arriving with my salad ready beside his plate of tacos, he spent the next half an hour telling me about his model ex-girlfriend and how passionate their breakup sex had been last weekend. The final straw was, even after telling him I wasn't a big fan of smoking, he literally asked a stranger for cigarettes and then chain smoked them beside me. Way late to the party apparently, but I feel obliged to share my best friend's story. He, you philosophool, I think was his username, died recently at age 23 from a massive seizure in his sleep, but he loved to tell this story, so I'll tell it here, so at least if I ever forget it I know at least I can find it. So this philosopher is a shy guy, timid, a bit neurotic. Dates are hard to come by for him, but when he's on them, he's nice and charming and fairly handsome. I'll give him that, so he doesn't do too bad once he's got a shot. Anyway, all us lads are on Tinder at this stage and we all have the philosophy always swipe, whichever way is, yes, so you get maximum matches and take it from there. Now there is this one girl who looks a bit rough, a bit unkept I'll say, and her description read, "I love giving BJs." Now philosophical was a very compassionate guy and talked to literally everyone he matched with and gave everyone at least one date. He didn't match with many, but bless him, he dated them all, including his GF up until his death. May she never read this. Full stop. He travels on a train to date this girl at her house. He recounted that from being picked up at the train station, the car was full of litter. The footwell was 90% litter, 10% his feet. And the woman from the photo, she had aged, not too kindly, either. And the house was run down, dirty, every room doubling as a bedroom for some cavern dweller from that part of town. My memory gets a little hazy here, but she asks him if he'd like tea. He says he would and he has some chamomile. In his words, the one clean thing I had in this house was that teacup and a chamomile tea. After a while of small talk and awkward experience, she asked him if he wanted a blowjob, assuring him she was really good at these. He finds a spot on the bed among the rubbish, cup of chamomile in hand, his only refuge of cleanliness, as the constant background dripping is drowned out by excessive slurping off his half-mast. He cuddles his warm tea thinking only of home. Man, the way he described it was a very funny and less like he's repulsed. Oh crap, my time to shine. Now I swear all is true. This girl I've been sweet talking for a few weeks and I finally set up a date to meet up and go out to this nice restaurant and have dinner. The night comes and she asks me to pick her up because her car is in the shop. I head over to the address and it's this confusing apartment complex, but quickly find her outside her building. But she asked me to meet her family, so I go and meet her mother, who is the sweetest woman ever, and her father, who was quiet but kind. After we leave, she immediately turns to me and says, "Can we pick up my cousin?" I'm shocked but say sure. I didn't really question it. We head to a really sketchy neighborhood in San Jose and pick up this super skinny tatted up white guy, and he asks who the frick I am, and I was about to say her date, but she cuts me off and says, "Oh, just a friend, don't worry about him." And he says, "Alright, babe." He then guides me two cities over to this crappy house where this really nicely dressed Asian guy meets us outside and takes us into the garage, where a cracked out skinny Mexican guy and pregnant white chicken sits us down in between. Then and asked our poison. My date said weed along with the Mexican guy and the cousin. The pregnant chick says, "I'm fine. Weed is bad for the baby," and then pulls out a crack pipe and starts smoking something. The Asian guy said, "Pay up," and everyone looks towards me, and I said, "Alright," and pulled $60 out of my wallet and asked if that's enough, and the Asian guy said, "It's fine." He leaves the garage taking my get the guest soda and comes back 10 awkward minutes later and stoned with nothing, saying, "Sorry guys, I'm out of weed, but my dealer is on his way." 20 minutes later he shows up screaming and throwing weed at the Mexican guy and just leaving. Then the Asian guy asked if anyone had a pipe and I said I did, and they all got happy, and I went outside to my car and drive off because I'm pretty sure I would have died that night. I had been talking to this girl on Tinder for a while and we decide we wanted to smash. The problem is I had asked my roommate if I could have the room later. Apparently, unlike the rest of the animals you people seem to have as roommates. So when I went to sign this girl in, we have a proctor in the lobby at my university's dorms. My roommate and several other friends of mine placed a Bluetooth speaker in my room and hid in the hallway, waiting for me to get back. I didn't see them and things started to get hot and heavy when "Let's Get It On" started playing from somewhere in the room. I started searching and after 5 minutes, while the song I just had sex was finishing playing, I found the Bluetooth speaker under my roommate's bed behind his dresser. Yes, I had to move both of them. I found the power button but not before the wonderful sound of hardcore pornography filled the room. The two of us decided to call it, so we threw on some clothes. I walked her past all 6 of the bastards. I never saw her again. Comma, unlike the rest of the animals you people seem to have as roommates. Comma, my roommate and several other friends of mine placed a Bluetooth speaker in my room and hid in the hallway. Met this girl on Tinder. Invited her into bed. She accepts. Comes over. We have fantastic sex. A lot. Same thing the next night. Thing is, she's moving to Montana in a few weeks for a job. A cook position in a national park. She invites me out there. I look into the job and eventually get it. We decide to start dating. Met twice. Known her for a month. I'm an idiot. To keep it exclusive at adult summer camp there in Montana. I get out there. She freaks out and breaks up with me because she has cancer. Cancels the breakup. Does it again the next night. I agree and say it's over. Proceeds to dong block me constantly throughout the summer and we scream at each other in the kitchen. Poor choices all around. As a man in a long-term pre-Tinder relationship, I'm really living vicariously through these stories and they are outstanding. Bless you people. This didn't actually come about through Tinder, but rather through an equivalent app. So, I meet the guy there and he's just incredible. Clever, good-looking, funny, you get the type. The only catch is that he doesn't live in my city. After a couple of weeks of messaging and phone calls, we decide to meet up and we settle on that I would be going to him because I'd never been to his city and that seemed like a fun little adventure. Right? Wrong? The big day comes and I embark on the 2.5-hour train journey and I get all excited and I can't wait to get off the train. And then he's not at the platform when I get off. Try to call him to no avail and after 4 hours of waiting, I decide to take the next train back home. Haven't heard from him since. TLDR. Met a guy from a different city relatively far away. Stands me up when I go out there to meet him. I don't really have a horror story, since I've gotten about 1 date out of Tinder which went alright. But I've been rejected plenty, the highlight of which was this girl, who seemed pretty interesting and was reasonably attractive. So I swiped right, and it turned out that we matched. Hooray. So, I send her a message. Something clever, along the lines of hey, a match. Did we just become best friends though? I can't take credit for that one. I did steal that from Reddit stepbrothers. Happily, she responded rather promptly, so I was eager to read what she'd sent. Cause for the most part women just kinda ignore me. Anyway, I open it up and all it said was I swiped the wrong way. That woman is a savage. Matched with a girl, and she was quite pretty in the face. All of her pictures were mostly of just her face upper body, but I didn't pay any mind. She initiated the conversation, and she was immediately into hooking up. So of course I invited her over. She gets there and I answer the door, and turns out she was about 6 feet 5 inches. I am 5 feet 8 inches on a good day. I let out an audible holy crap and she picked me up and carried me to the bedroom like a baby. No regrets. Advice welcome. So I went on 3 dates with this dude and we hooked up the last time at his house. Things end with the typical fade away. I was fine with it. We weren't very compatible and I noticed a few minor red flags. 6 months later he starts emailing me, obviously looking for a reenactment of our summer fling. When I turn down his advances, he sends me a screenshot of myself, in his bedroom, while we were hooking up, half a year ago. So obviously this douche nozzle filmed us without my consent. I reported it to the police and now, almost a year after I filed the report, I have to testify against the creep. I have no legal rep except the state's victim advocate who only seems to have experience with DV cases. Has anyone else been through something like this? I can't find a way to report him via Tinder. I deleted my account a long time ago. My biggest concern is that he's still out there being a creep to other ladies on Tinder. Downloaded Tinder for quick and simple hookups. First couple matches were pretty decent. Drinks, sex, etc. The third girl, however, wanted to take things a little slower. First date, a little making out. Second date, same thing but still won't go home with me. Third date, we had some really awkward sex with the lights on and no music. I was so nervous. I had a hard time keeping it up and she was barely wet. We've been dating for 10 months and she is going to meet my parents this weekend. The horror. Happened a year ago. Met this guy. Similar interests. Looked great in his pictures. We decided to meet up on a Sunday for lunch. I was so hungover from a friend's Christmas party that I threw up upon arrival. He didn't seem to mind. He didn't order a drink and I couldn't order one due to the hangover. Once the hangover subsided, I suggested we walk around and head into a bar. He doesn't like the first bar, had a bad experience at the next bar, and keeps on passing on them. Until we finally get to his favorite bar, he orders drinks, and after a few more drinks I suggest heading to a wine bar. He passes, because he confesses that he's only 20, and while his profile said he worked at a local college, it was a work study position, because he is a junior there. Maybe it was the hangover, maybe it was the exhaustion, but I still brought him home. Things occurred, and I found out he was a virgin. He ran away in tears and threw up on my apartment stairs. Repeated the process once he was 21, and it was almost the same situation. Never again. We talked for a couple of hours, drank some wine, watched a movie and we had sex. Then things went a little downhill. We laid in bed and suddenly it looked like she was about to black out, so I helped her sit right up and asked if I could help her, get her some water and stuff. But she didn't speak a word. She just sat there with her hands in her hair for a couple of minutes and then puked all over my sheets. At this point I wanted to get her to the shower ASAP, but she was just stunned or something. I didn't know what to do. After a couple minutes I finally convinced her to get up and brought her to the shower so she could clean herself while I could clean the sheets and all that. Every 5 minutes I checked on her if she was okay, but she would just sit on the floor with the shower running and wouldn't talk. It was all very awkward. After 20 minutes or so I brought her a towel and some clothes and we sat on the edge of my bed and she told me that she was born without a womb. She cried. I calmed her down and we finally went to sleep, without a blanket or sheets. I didn't have spare ones in my student apartment. The next day I made breakfast and she went home. Weirdest date I ever had. I matched this pretty cute looking girl. She didn't look like she was in super great shape, but she didn't look obese or anything. Well, we exchanged numbers and I called her. She agreed to come over to my house, so I waited outside while she found her way over. She pulls up in a super badass car, so I'm like, heck yeah. When she gets out, it looked like her suspension let out a sigh of relief. She was at least 300 pounds. Nice girl though. She gave me a back massage, then I told her I was tired afterwards and she left. I'm a little late to the party, but my first Tinder date has been my most eventful date ever. So I matched this absolutely drop-dead gorgeous girl, way out of my league, and we arranged to meet in the city for a few drinks on a Friday evening. We meet in this little bar and share a drink. The conversation is a lot of small talk to begin with, but it's flowing well. Anyway, we're there for about 30 minutes when she says she hasn't eaten anything yet and asks if I wanna grab a bite to eat. I do. So we finish our drinks and start moving outside to find some food. As we're walking along the sidewalk, I see this guy in front of me staring me down. Like he is proper shooting daggers at me and making me super uncomfortable. I try to ignore him. Look at the ground. Look at the girl. Whatever. We move to pass him and he spins around on his heel and slams me into a wall. He has his forearm pressed up against my neck and is pushing so hard my feet are starting to lift off the ground. I try and pull his arm away from my throat, unsuccessfully, and my vision is starting to go black. I thought I was done for here. In a last ditch effort to not be strangled to death, I use the wall as a board to push my knee up into him as hard as I can. I hit him square in the groin and he relinquishes his grip. My vision starts to return, although it's giving me a splitting headache. I splutter and try and get my breath back a bit while I watch this guy curl over, red in the face with veins popping out of his forehead. He stumbles over to the street and throws up all through the gutter. I turn to the girl who's just watching all of this like a ruin headlights. Turns out, the guy was her ex-boyfriend who heard about our date through a mutual friend of theirs. I managed to wheeze out enough to ask her if she'd like to get another drink with me, as I could really use one. She declines and says she's just going to get a ride home, and practically sprints away from whatever the heck this situation was. I ended up leaving this other guy puking in the street and stayed out for a few hours by myself. Had a really good night in the end. Met a bunch of new people and a pretty fun story, in hindsight. Went out with a girl, and had a great time together. I only knew her first name. We were texting later that night after our date and I told her to add me on Snapchat and gave her my username. She added me and up popped a request from first name last name. Her last name being my mom's very rare maiden name. She was my second cousin. We clarified things briefly and never spoke again. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.